So Prussian half-air rectifier. So the Prussian half-air rectifier, as the name itself tells, precision. Prussian means exactness, precise value. So here the specialty of this kind of rectifier is, you know that for the diode to operate, it needs minimum of 0.7 volts. That means only after 0.7 volt the diode starts conducting. But here what we have done is the same half-way rectifier. Half-way rectifier means what it is going to do? It is going to rectify half of the input signal such that you will be getting only half of the output. I mean half of the input signal at the output. Only one cycle you will be getting. The negative cycle you will be not getting. So in this case, in the rectifier which you have already studied in basic electronics and all, we were doing a transformer we were using, and we were using a diode. So because of that, only the signal which is greater than 0.7 volt that was getting out. Until that, the diode was reverse biased. But here, in order to avoid that, what we are going to do here is, we are going to connect an op amp. We are going to connect an op amp before the diode. So if you are going to give an input signal to the diode, then it is going to start conducting. It is going to start conducting. Let us take this is the input signal we are having, and let us assume this is 0 to 10 volt and minus 10 volt. Here this diode was allowing the voltage or the current to pass through only after 0.7, right? Only after 0.7. until 0.7 my output was zero. After 0.7 only the output was getting displayed. So in order to overcome that problem, what they have done is, they are giving this input signal, instead of giving it to the diode directly, they are giving it to an op amp, operational amplifier. This operational amplifier, what it is going to give is, whatever the input signal we are giving, 0.7 volt or 0.1 volt or any voltage which is lesser than 0.7, that will be amplified to higher level. If you have 0.1 volt, that 0.1 volt might come here as 1 volt. So for 1 volt, the diode will forward bias or reverse bias? Hello? For 1 volt, the diode is going to forward bias or reverse bias?
Forward bias.
Forward bias. So what this op-amp is going to do is, it is going to amplify the lower voltages to next higher levels. It might be 0.2 volt might be amplified to 2 volts. So even now also the diode gets forward biased. So now because of this, what happens is, even at 0.1 volt the diode gets forward biased. Because of that, in our earlier cases where we were having the signal which is greater than 0.7, then only we are getting the output. But here in this case, what happens, because of the usage of this op amp, even the voltage which is lesser than 0.7 is also being considered at the output. How it is considered? Because of the amplification through this op amp. So whatever the voltage we give here, that is amplified and given here, such that the 0.1 volt also we are getting the output. During input is 0.1 volt also we are getting the output. When I compare my input signal with my output signal, we could see that even at this point, this is 0.1, means even at that 0.1 I have some voltage. So this is what the specialty of this Prussian half-way rectifier. So Prussian half-way rectifier, they start conducting even at lower voltages. That's why we go for this Prussian half-way rectifier. Let us see the working of this. Here the input is given to the positive terminal, and the feedback is taken from the output to the negative terminal. This is a non-inverting terminal, this is inverting terminal. Now during positive half cycle, what happens, since we are giving the input to the non-inverting terminal, so can you tell me whether the output will be inverted form of input or it will be as it is? I'm giving the positive phase of the input signal. When I'm giving positive phase of the input signal, the output is going to be a positive output or negative output or inverted output.
Positive, sir.
Positive output.
Positive output you'll be getting. So when you're getting positive output, during that time what happens automatically, the diode gets forward biased. Positive output also, it is amplified version of the input signal. It is positive as well as amplified version of the input signal. Because of this, what happens? The diode starts conducting. When the diode starts conducting, automatically we'll be getting the output across this. So whatever you are getting, whatever you are giving at the input, that output will be displayed across this load resistance. So that load, the voltage across the load is V naught, we'll get the output. So for entire positive half cycle, we'll get. Next, during negative half cycle, what happens? During negative half cycle, whatever we are giving at the non-inverting terminal, what will be the output? Whether it will be negative or positive? During negative half cycle, what happens? The output of op amp, whether it is the negative output or positive output,
it won't give an output.
It won't be, because it's only half wave.
It's I'm
just talking about the output of op amp. I'm not talking about this output at this point before giving it to diode. Before giving it to diode, what will be my output? Whether it is a negative output or positive output? If it is negative output, why it is negative?
Negative.
Why it is negative? Why not positive?
Negative.
Negative output.
Why it is negative?
Sir, because it is negative output, so the diode is forward biased. So I don't think the diode will conduct, and hence we don't get the wave for.
Yeah, I'm asking negative. You one thing. See here. I'm giving negative. I'm getting negative only. Why I'm getting the same? Why not the inverted form?
Because it is non-inverting.
Yes, because it is non-inverting terminal. When you use non-inverting terminal, during that case, whatever the signal, whatever the phase you give, the same phase will be coming at the output. There'll be no change in the phase. Okay. So now at this point, the voltage, whatever we get, it might be an amplified version of the input, but it is negative. Because of that, what happens? The diode gets reverse biased. When the diode gets reverse biased, the output is zero. When the output is zero, we'll not get any output. The output is zero. So we'll be able to produce only the positive phase and we'll be not having negative phase. That's why it is known as half wave rectifier. A rectifier, what is rectifier? It's a device which is going to convert AC to DC. Even though it is not a pure DC, but still, this is the first stage of rectification. Later on, we'll filter it. Later on, we regulate it. All those things are there. But in this case, the rectification takes place only to the half of the signal. This is precision half-wave rectifier. Advantages over simple diode. What is the advantage over a simple diode? Can anyone tell me? What might be the advantage?
Normal diode needs 0.7 volt. This might not need it.
Normal diode?
This is very pretty. Like, sir, the name itself says, so we'll get this.
Okay. So that means here in this case, precise values will be getting. At the same time, the minimum, at the minimum voltage level also, this diode starts conducting. Whatever might be the input at this point, but what is the input we are giving here? It is 0.1, but for 0.1 also diode is operating, right? So whatever might happen at this phase, it might be an amplified version, but we just consider this part and this part always, the input what we give and output what we get. So between these two, we are going to consider, we are going to compare. So that's why this input voltage, even though at 0.1 volt, this diode is conducting. That is one of the best advantages. So ability to rectify very small voltage, even less than 0.7 volt diode forward voltage drop. Amplification can be achieved. It has low output impedance. It has, there is no diode voltage drop. Yes, there is no question of diode drop because even it is operating at 0.1 volt also. So previously we were calling diode drop because the diode was not allowing the output until my input reaches greater than 0.7 volt. So that is the drawback which we had in a normal diode, and this is the advantage what we have in our regular precision half wave rectifier, this diode. Yeah. So next is for saturating precision half wave rectifier. So for higher level voltage, we go for this one. So here you can just see we have the same thing. Whatever we had here, the same circuit we have, but the only change is here we had a feedback which is not having any resistance. So that means when feedback is given here without any resistance, what happens? That gain will act as unity. So gain will be unity. See, I'll ask you one question. If this diode is also not present, can you tell me what kind of op amp it will be?
Feedback.
What?
Feedback. The output is given back to the inverting terminal. Negative feedback.
Voltage follower. Same, because the gain is not present here, because the gain is mainly dependent upon what? The resistance what we connect across the inverting terminal, right? RF, the feedback resistance, and RI, the input resistance. So based on that resistances, we'll be able to produce some amplification. But here, since there is no feedback resistance, automatically the gain is unity, gain is one. So output follows the input. But now when you put a diode here, this becomes a precision rectifier. For the voltage follower, if you put a diode, it becomes precision rectifier. But now I want higher level of amplification. Then what I'll do is, I'll be just going on with some resistances like this. What you call this kind of resistance? This kind of connection.
Voltage divider
connection. At the same time, analyze this R1 and R2. How it looks? See, R1, does it looks like a feedback to this? See, starting from this point, starting from this point, see, this is the feedback we are having. So this is R1 is acting like a feedback resistance, RF. Okay, see this R2. Instead of connecting this R2 here, can I connect this R2 here also? Or does it make any change? Connecting here, this R2 I'll remove here, this R2 I'll remove here, and I'll connect it here. Like this. How it will look like? Just assume that this is not there. This is not there. How it look like now? Input is given to positive terminal and feedback is there. Just recap op amps. How it looks like?
It Differentiator or something, sir.
Differentiator. Differentiator means you should have a capacitor.
Oh, yeah.
Difference means you should have two inputs. I mean, both two inputs you have to supply. Here we are supplying only one input. What you call an op amp where input is given to the positive terminal, non-inverting op amp, is it?
Yes, sir.
When input is given to the positive terminal, we call it as non-inverting op amp. At the same time, we know that we'll leave out everything. We'll just think on what we had studied in basic electronics. See, there in basic electronics, we study about the properties of ideal and practical op amps. There we tell that practical op amp has an open loop gain of 2 into 10 to the power of 5, right? The open loop gain was 2 into 10 to the power of 5. So, you know, but all our application will not require 2 into 10 to the power of 5 gain. That's why what we do is we connect a feedback from output to input such that this gain will be reduced according to our requirement. Because see, an mobile requires only some particular gain and loudspeaker requires some particular gain. The gain of loudspeaker cannot be applied to a mobile, where a mobile can get damaged. At the same time, the gain what a mobile required, that might not satisfy a loudspeaker, right? So in order to reduce or in order to tune this gain, what they started is, they started with the feedback. So that feedback, when it is given to the negative terminal, that was acting like gain adjustment or gain adjuster. So now here we are having RF and we are having R2. So when this kind of connection is given, we call it as non-inverting operational amplifier, where input is given to the non-inverting terminal and the inverting terminal will be grounded. See, R2 is the resistance of the inverting terminal, that is grounded. And what is R1? R1 is acting like a feedback resistance. See, I have told you already, this feedback resistance, if you are connecting it to the inverting terminal, then it will be acting like a gain reducer or gain adjuster. But if the same feedback is connected to the positive terminal, then it will act like a positive feedback. Positive feedback means it will be still increasing the gain. But here what we want, we have to decrease, because 2 into 10 to the power of 5, that much, that is almost 2 lakh. 2 lakh gain is not required for any device. So we have to reduce it to 100, 200, 1000 based upon our requirement. That's why we use RF and R2. And for non-inverting op amp, what is the formula for gain? What is the formula for gain?
Minus RF by R1.
Non-inverting op amp.
So 1 plus RF by R1 into V.
1 plus RF by R1. This is the gain.
Into
V in means that is your output voltage. That is the output voltage formula.
Yeah, output voltage.
Gain means 1 plus RF by R1. So here RF is R1. R1 is this R2. So this is a non-inverting amplifier. Okay. So this non-inverting, till here all of you understood?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
So now you came to know that this circuit is whatever, except this diode, it is a non-inverting circuit, non-inverting op amp circuit we have connected. So non-inverting op amp we have connected means it is going to provide amplification. You'll agree with me? It is providing amplification, because since we are adding this R1, R2, it is going to add some gain, right? But what was happening in our last case here? There was no resistance connected. That's why the gain was unity. The gain was unity. But now I want to add some gain, or I want to adjust the gain. So that's why I'm using R1 and R2. These two will add some gain or adjust some gain. So now again the same working. Input is given here to the non-inverting terminal. During positive half cycle, even the point one might get amplified to some higher level. Because of that, the diode gets forward bias and you'll be getting the output. So you can observe the output. See, this is the input level and this is the output level. Can you see the level of the output is increased compared to the input, the peak value? The peak value has increased. The peak value of the voltage has increased, yes, compared to the input. That means this circuit, whatever we are using here, this is going to add, along with rectification, it is going to add some gain to the input. So such type of circuit is known as saturating Prussian half wave rectifier. If they are asking, this is normal Prussian half wave rectifier, and this might not be, sometimes this might not be a saturating, so it will be normal rectifier. But if they precisely asked you saturating Prussian half wave rectifier, then you have to write this one where you'll have R1 R2. So this is about the half wave rectifier. Next, non-saturating half wave rectifier. So non-saturating half wave rectifier means here there is no saturation. Here there was saturation, that means it was going to the peak value, but here it is not going to any highest level, it is almost the same. But the non-saturating half wave rectifier, the circuit is quite complex, looks complex, but there is nothing in this. So just you need to understand how the diodes are going to work. So for non-saturating half wave rectifier, Prussian rectifier, we are going to give the input to the inverting terminal. Since we are giving input to the inverting terminal, the output will be the rectified output will be the inverted form. So for the positive phase will not have any output, for negative phase will have output. Why it happens like that, let us see. Now let us assume an input signal. Input signal is assumed like this. So this is the positive signal, this is the positive part which is applied here. So when it is applied here, the positive signal is applied to the negative terminal, what you are going to expect at this point? The inverted form, obviously, right? The positive signal which was given like this, that will become inverted. That means this plus becomes minus here. The positive voltage becomes negative voltage here. At the same time, the same voltage will be applied to this and as well as to this. Now, here we are having negative. So that means here also we are having negative. But what you have at this point, at this diode, whether you have negative or positive? This end, at this end, whether you have
positive,
you have positive, right? At the same time,
yes,
and it is connected here. Now this is positive and this is negative. What happens to this diode? What happens to
forward bias?
It becomes
forward bias.
Forward biased.
Forward bias.
Okay. Now what happens to this diode? Since this is negative, this becomes reverse biased.
Reverse bias.
Okay. When this becomes reverse biased, now what will be the output across this point?
It'll be zero.
Will it be zero or something else? See,
I'm doing positive half cycle.
Positive cycle, this is positive and this is negative. So this is also negative. This point is negative. This is positive, means here also this will be positive, this will be positive, this will be the negative, this also will be the negative, and this will be positive, this is negative. So this becomes forward biased, this becomes reverse biased. Is there any possibility of the voltage to flow across the output?
No,
there is no possibility. see, you would have considered this R2 and R1 as gain, because someone might think like this, R2 and R1 are there, no, why can't you consider that with respect to this? See, you can consider R2 and R1 as gain only when this op amp is connected to output. But here what has happened, the output is not connected to this terminal because this is open circuited. When this is open circuited, this wire becomes open. So there is no connection between this point to this point, or op amp's output terminal, this output terminal is having no connection with this. So obviously what happens, output will be zero. It will be not having any signal. Next, we will take negative half cycle. I take negative half cycle here. So because of which, what I'll get at the output? I have a negative half cycle here. This is the negative half cycle I have. What I'll get here? Positive half cycle I'll get. This is the positive half cycle I'm getting. So when this is negative half cycle, what happens? This is negative. This is positive. And what happens to this? Even this is also positive. Now tell me whether D1 is forward biased or D2 is forward biased.
D2 is forward biased.
D2 is forward biased. What about D1? Since this is positive and this is negative,
D1 is reverse biased.
It becomes reverse biased. This is reverse biased. So because of reverse biased, what happens? This becomes open. This connection becomes open. Since this is forward biased, what happens? This acts like a short circuit. Right? Now, how it looks like? Just neglect this part. Ignore this. How this looks like, the circuit.
Same as the previous one.
Previous one? So no, I'm just asking with respect to op amp. Yeah, does it matches any of our op amps? Does it matches
non-inverting
op amp, right? For non-inverting op amp, what is the formula we have? V naught is equal to, what is the formula? Non-inverting op amp. Leah?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what is the formula for non-inverting op amp? Is it, it's a non-inverting, first of all. Input is given to
inverting. Sir.
Inverting. Hmm. Inverting op amp. What is the formula? Hmm. Minus RS.
RF by R1 into
VIN.
VIN. Right. This is the formula we are having. So this circuit, whenever it, you are giving negative input during that time, it acts like a inverting op amp. So you are giving input signal as the negative phase, but what is the output you are getting? You are getting positive phase because it has to invert. No, input and output should be inverted form of each other. So what happens in the negative signal, whatever we have, you'll get that at positive phase. But again, you can see the negative phase and the positive phase. It is amplified. Why it is amplified? It is amplified because of the presence of this RF and R1. RF and R1. See here, we have non-saturating because they're having their inverse of each other. But the earlier case, we were calling it as saturated because they were not having any inverse. The phase difference was same. Here, the phase difference is different. Here, the input and output are having a phase difference of 180 degree. But in saturating op amp, input and output are having same phase difference. The phase difference was zero. Here the phase difference is 180 degree. That's why the name non-saturating. So after this, that is the formula is V0 is equal to minus VI R2 by R1. The same thing is explained here. Yeah. Coming to this, in whenever we study in last fourth and fifth, we have problems and they'll ask you design non-saturating half-wave rectifier. then you have to design it. So while designing, there is a procedure, some 4 to 5 steps procedure will be there. So design procedure, first thing what we assume is I1 is very, very greater than IB max. What is I1? I1 is the current which is coming here. IB max means what? The current which is going to the negative terminal of this op amp. Because you know the internal structure of op amp. What does an op amp contains internally? What does an op amp contains internally? Nobody knows.
And basically, resistors and capacitors, sir.
Only resistors and capacitor.
Yes, sir.
Operational amplifier. Amplifier means what?
Diode.
Transistor, sir.
Amplifier means first thing that should come to is transistor. Without transistor, you cannot amplify. Diode will never amplify anything. Diode is not an amplifier at all. It cannot amplify anything. It can act only like a switch. Forward bias to on switch, reverse bias off switch. But transistor is the device which is used as an amplifier. Inside this op amp, we have transistors. One transistor for non-inverting, one transistor for inverting. Both of them will be coupled together. Okay, I'll send you the pic. That is, if you have my basic electronics book, there is a topic called the internal structure or ideal op amp. In ideal op amp, actually that is there. I think you might have studied in basic electronics. That is there for syllabus also. You will have two transistors, difference amplifier internal structure will be studying, where two transistors will be connected and the base will be given. One base will be given here and other transistor's base will be given here. Do you know that the resistance of the base is maximum? That is, it is in terms of mega ohm. When the resistance is at mega ohm, of the base is at mega ohm, what happens? The current through this terminals will be very, very less. Why? Because the current, the terminals, negative and positive terminals, are the base of the transistor. We know that. According to even emitter base collector also, emitter is heavily doped, base is lightly doped, collector is moderately doped, and we'll tell emitter and collector will have milliamperes of current, base will be having microamperes of current. And also we connect, we know that input impedance of an op amp is maximum and output impedance of an op amp is minimum. These are all the characteristics which you have already studied. According to that case, though, this is the base current IB. So what we are assuming is, the first step is IB is very, very less compared to I1. That is, I1 is assumed to be 500 microampere. So here we are assuming an op amp MUA741. You have whatever you are using in the lab, MUA741 op amp, the same op amp. So that is the first step. First we'll assume current to find R1, R2, R3. So if you know this design procedure, no, you can easily do the problem. Same steps you'll be using for problems. I1, you got it. And this is assumption. For all problems, you'll assume like this only. Second step, to find R1, R2, R3. So how you'll find R1? This one, this is the R1. How you'll find R1? It is, R1 is connected between this point and this point. And this is our current. What is this current? I1. And what is this junction known as? According to op amps basics, what is the junction known as? Virtual ground.
Virtual ground.
Right, virtual ground. What is virtual ground? It is, the voltage at this point will be same as the voltage across
the
non-inverting terminal. If non-inverting terminal is grounded, the voltage at this point will be zero. If non-inverting terminal is having some voltage, the same voltage appears here. That is what. So here, in this case, the non-inverting terminal is grounded. So what will be the voltage at this point?
Zero.
Vi minus zero. Okay. So R1, what is the formula for R1 now? R1 is equal to, if this is I1 is the current flowing, R1 is equal to Vi minus 0 divided by I1. That is the how you find R1. Next, similarly R2, V0 by I1. Then R3. So R3, how we are going to find? So you can see R3, this, if you are having two terminals, then two terminals, the resistance should be same. The because of, in order to have a balanced circuit, the resistance of the non-inverting terminal and resistance of the inverting terminal should be same. So if the resistance of the non-inverting terminal is R3, what will be the resistance of the inverting terminal? Resistance of the inverting terminal is R1, and also we have connection with R2. How they are connected? R1 and R2, how they are connected? Are they connected series or parallel?
Series.
Series. Noreen.
Yes, sir.
This parallel.
How they are connected? R1 and R2. Parallel, no? Because at this point, more than two wires are meeting at this junction. So they are parallel. So what we write? R3 is equal to R1 parallel R2. Okay. For diode D1 and D2, we consider it is greater than VCC minus of minus VEE. After that, reverse recovery time. So reverse recovery time is T by 10, we consider. So T is 1 by F. F is frequency of the signal and time period is T. So what is reverse recovery time? Basic electronics again, first module. I think I have to first finish up basic electronics, then I should start AC. What is reverse recovery time? It is the time taken by the diode to shift from positive phase to negative phase, or it is the time taken by the diode to move from forward bias to reverse bias condition. Okay, that is reverse recovery time. From that reverse recovery time only, we are going to find the frequency. Okay. So based on this only, we are going to solve this problems. And after that, we have two output precision rectifier. Two output precision rectifier is nothing but almost it is a full wave rectifier. Okay. We'll stop it here and we'll continue it in the